Exeter Historical Society came into being in 1964, owing to the efforts of some local people who had a great interest in things of a historical nature and the people who settled in the district in the early 1800s. The driving forces of the society when it was in its infancy were people the likes of John F. Gorman, who was possessed of a remarkably retentive memory of events relative to this district. A retired banker, Hugh Ross, who devoted hundreds of hours of volunteer work to the establishment of the society. Marjorie Coff, who in her time as president took the society to great heights and standing in the local community. The Baxters, Bill and Orb, were to devote their energies to the collection of artefacts. In the early days of the society's being, it was very fortunate to have the services of a high school teacher who taught pupils how to use the newly arrived computers. His name was Graham Lawrence. Graham assumed the role of secretary of the society and carried out this office with due care and diligence. Over the 44 years of the society's being, it has been most fortunate to have been recipient of the services of capable and talented members. And this situation has continued on to this day, where we see the society under the control of a dedicated and learned executive. This body is headed by the dynamic chairperson of Jan Lear. Since Jan's entry into the society's ranks, we have been brought out of the pen and paper stage to a situation of high-class IT technology, while still retaining the objects of our original charter, which basically stands for the Society to Research, Collect and Store Local History and Artifacts. It wasn't until 1971 that the Society had a home for its collection of artifacts, and this came about through the demise of the Victorian Railways relinquishing the rail service from Branxholme to Casterton. This event left in Casterton a magnificent railway station of 6 rooms built out of clinker bricks, the first railway station of this design in the railways system. It became known when built on other sites as the Casterton design. The local shire took control of this building and in turn entered into an agreement with the society to occupy it, which it does to this very day. To give you some idea of the interest our society claimed from the local residents, it is recorded that 110 people turned up for the first working bee at the railway precinct, where the object was to convert the railway station into a museum. The late Hugh Ross spent hundreds of volunteer hours painting the inside of the rooms and arranging artefacts for exhibition. Some of these were donated to the society, while some were on a permanent loan basis. They represent a lifestyle quite different to that of the present day. Over the years, our society has been the recipient of some items of immense interest. One of our most historic items, which was saved from the scrap metal dealers, is a Turkish Army, German-made, 6-inch howitzer, used by the Turks in World War I. This cannon was restored by the society members and is housed in an undercover site adjacent to our museum. We are also most fortunate to have within our ranks one Vern McCallum, a professional photography restorer, Burns' collection of ancient photos recording the events and places of interest around Caston and the district is nothing less than remarkable. Interest is still shown in our society, where a membership of 30 plus still enjoy researching and recording local history and families. Our railway museum is open to the public and sees quite a number of people who, when passing through Casterton, express a wish to visit it.